beforehand, just little small things.
There's very little really you can do with an experienced player like Newcomb to help him. There's Clarence. Coached at Trinity College for years, very, very successful. Fine gentleman. Here comes Newcomb. Here comes Connors. Pretty short. Newcomb's in the right spot. Good low return down the line that time. It's really tough to make that low volley when you're coming in, when you have to stretch wide. Bad error by that Newcomb that time.
13-15.
Best of five set match. If we get to a tiebreaker, it's a 12-point tiebreaker. They'll use. I have a feeling we might get there this set, Pat.
Looks like it. Connor's serving at 3-4 now. Have to win by two if we get into that tiebreaker. Service ace by Connor. That's his third.
And he has not served a double fault. Newcomb has served four aces, but he served three doubles. Strike out a man and walk somebody. Serve to the forehand in the discourse. Worked beautifully for Jimmy Connors.
Games are four all, second set.
Newcomb's got a blister, by the way, on the inside of his right hand, down close to the base of his third finger. Talked to him about it yesterday, and he said he didn't think it would bother.
I'm sure they have some tape handy.
Yeah.
Four all in the second set. That's a good reason to get your first serve in, Pat. What do you think? Think Rod Laver's watching this?
I would imagine. He's able to get where he can.
15-all.
Connors thought the serve was not good.
13-15.
Pancho Segura standing up out of chair, trying to get Jimmy's eyes to relax now. Don't let it bother you. There's Pancho. Super guy.
Try to come down the line.
14-15.
Could have bet me he'd have gone cross court with that one, too. I'd have been on the other side.
Newcomb was there.
40-15.
Whoa, look at that. Beautiful shot.
And that time Newcomb did look for the cross court.
40-30.
Take a look at that again. Newcomb did a good job to make this kind of a volley. Now he gets back to the center and looking to the right, and Connors went back down the line. Watch where this hits. Just inside the sideline, just inside the baseline, like it had eyes.
Perfect shot.
And on the dead run.
40-30. Newcomb serving.
Overhead smash wins for John Newcomb, and he now leads 5-4 in the second set.
We'll be back with more tennis action after this word from your local station.
Game, 60 Minutes looks at the game of hockey, its violence, and its strange fascination. Tomorrow at 6, 5 Central on CBS.
Someday soon, you're going to buy a beer for someone you like. We'd like to suggest that instead of beer, you reward him with Ballantine Ale. Your friend will ask you, why ale? Tell him about the X's. Tell him the three X's mean Ballantine Ale tastes spectacular. That it's among the finest tasting ales ever brewed. And tell him that with Ballantine Ale, taste is what it's all about.
Robert Morley of British Airways, we love you in America.
Oh, madam, how kind. Mind you, I'm not surprised. The Tower of London for under a dollar. Not to take away, of course. Lunch at the country pub, 95 cents. And there's no charge for the scenery. But the biggest bargain of them all is British Airways London Show Tour.
It's cheaper than any other airline.
Is there another airline?
Group inclusive tour prices subject to change and to special conditions detailed in our holidays brochure.
Channel 2, New York.
That is how we're able to get those low-level camera shots that you see at CBS cameraman Walt Dineer. Standing behind him, Jack Whitaker, from whom we'll hear a little bit later. And there's the shot from Walt's camera.
One poor soul threw a ball back in the corner.
There was a little discussion about returning the balls when the tennis ball goes up into the crowd. The spectators want to keep them as a souvenir, because that's Newcomb with Clarence Mabry. But Gus Lann explained that we need the balls returned so the players are playing with the balls that are the same weight, the same fuzziness, they're used in the same grip. You can't throw the ball out.
Tony, I noticed in one of the sections of the many written words that we've had about this challenge match that the balls were opened 2 days ago. Why would that be?
To slow it down a little bit so they're not quite as fast. And obviously that has to be by mutual agreement. I guess it's one of the things they didn't argue about. Okay, Connor's about to serve. It's 4-5 in the second set. He's won the first set 6-3.
That's that same shot.
Love, 15.
Just caught the tape trying to go down the line. Short second serve. And one of the few tentative swings that we've seen out of Jimmy Connors. He did not really go at either one of those forehands. It's now love 30.
Most unusual to see him not hit out with everything he's got.
No matter what the score is.
Right.
Jimmy's slowly digging a little bit of a hole for himself here. Matter of fact, he's 2 points away from losing this second set. John Newcomb hit a terrific approach shot.
Newcomb talking to Clarence Mabry now about something.
He's asking, and someone in the crowd hollered something while the ball was in play. They've asked.
If they're out or in, let the linesman do it. As I said last time, if you do it, you will be out.
Rather subtle comment from Gus Lerner.
Yeah, if you got something on your mind, say it. Yeah. Don't be vague.
15-30.
You will be out.
Well, that was a big point. That would have been triple set point for Newcomb had he made that backhand volley. He missed it by 8-10 feet over the sideline. 15-30. Jimmy's first serve has deserted him in this game. Thank you. one-handers. Stick the net and stayed in play. Newcomb is staying up the center more, taking the angle away from Connors. .1540 double set point for John Newcomb. Newcomb needs one of the next 2 points to level this match at one set apiece.
Bill Reardon, with his head down as you would expect. Good serve. Still set point.
One thing Pancho Segura said, I said, do you think Jimmy will come in behind his serve? He said, not all the time, but I'll guarantee he'll go in on the crucial points. He did it just then, but he came in behind a beautiful serve.
Another crucial point coming right here. Let's see if he comes in.
See John Newcomb jogging, bouncing up and down. Keep the adrenaline flowing.
Connor's taking a long time.
This will be an interesting second serve. Let's see how deep Connors gets it. Good second serve. Just about down the sideline. Newcomb down on his knees.
And again, Connors came in.
Nuke was trying to use a little body English like you do, like we do when we putt. Connors holds his heart. Saved 2 set points with some fine tennis. It's deuce.
He trails 4-5 in the second set.
Serve is out. See if he kicks this one out onto Newcomb's forehand. Nuke was looking for it.
Jumped on it.
It was out. It was out over the baseline. It was out, and it's now set point once again for John Newcomb.
Segura's up. And Connors questions, but it was out. Set point again for Newcomb.
Set point number 3.
Johnny Carson's got his coat off.
Connors tried to get to that passing shot as quickly as he could to get it cross court before Nuke could recover and just barely hit it out over the baseline. The base linesman called the ball immediately, but they're sitting in the box seats and it's hard for the players to see them sometimes.
Game and second set, Mr. Newcomb, 6-4. That's a win-all.
You might recall, beginning of the show, we showed you some of the tape from the Australian Open Championships. In the tiebreaker in a 4-set, John Newcomb made just about the same kind of backhand return for a winner at a very crucial time. When Nuke made that one, he jumped right off the ground.
Newcomb to serve to Connors. First game, third set now. Good serve it was.
15-love.
Ball bouncing at the other end of the court.
Ball.
Newcomb had been serving more to the one-handed side of Connors. That time he went up the center. Hit it very well, and I think Jimmy was looking for something to come out the other side. So it's 30 love. Another good defensive lob right on the baseline. Pancho Segura a little bit worried. Mrs. Connors a little bit worried. Jimmy Connors concentrating, waiting to return service. 40 love.
Ball.
Double ball.
Ball, double ball.
That's number four for Newcomb.
15.
If there's such a thing as a good time, if you're going to hit a double fault, that's about the best time you can when you're up 40 love. But it's interesting how quickly a 40 love lead can evaporate.
And as it evaporates, you are bound to go back and think about that double fault. 40-30 now.
When you're going to serve second serves as hard as Newcomb serves them, he's going to serve some double faults as well. 40-30. And John Newcomb holds serve to lead one love in the third set.
Here it is. We'll be back with more tennis action of the Connors-Newcomb Challenge match in just a moment.
Hey, Bunny Gruber, you gorgeous fashion model. How's your love life?
You're asking me?
Yeah.
You're asking this body? This face?
Oh, I'm asking. How's your love life?
Don't ask.
How's your love life?
Maybe yours needs Ultra Bright. Dynamite taste and more whitener than any leading toothpaste. Ultra Bright, the one that puts sex appeal in a tube, wants to know.
How's your love life?
Ultra Bright's just waiting to help yours.
1975 Opel. To those of you who have admired Opel's rugged disposition and frugal four-cylinder engine, we make this brief but proud announcement. Fuel injection. Now in Opel Manta, 1900 sedan, and sport wagon. These special edition Opels are at your Buick Opel dealer now. But you'd better hurry, because you know what happens when you put fuel injection in great little cars like these. They go fast. Buick's Opel, dedicated to the free spirit in just about everyone.
A massage and a hot shower. Together they work wonders on the aches and pains of life. And now there's a shower massage by Waterpik. A way to get a massage every time you shower. Thousands of tiny bursts of water adjust for a gentle, relaxing massage. A brisk, invigorating massage or a regular shower. The shower massage by Waterpik installs easily. A special gift for someone special.
You think Connors is nervous? He was just singing to Pancho Segura.
It's now or never, he said. Okay, my man.
Tell me what I'm doing. Connors will serve now with new balls. From the far court to Newcomb.
Hold it just a minute.
And Gus Lana says, hold it a second.
Will you please?
Crowd is shuffling around again.
In the aisle. Thank you. Glad.
Service ace for Jimmy Connors. That's number four.
Love.
A surprising type of ace because it was more from spin, the kick serve wide, rather than speed, but perfectly placed.
That's first service.
Sets are one apiece. Connors won the first one 6-3, Newcomb the second 6-4. Newcomb held service in the first game of the third set.
Done a lot of talking about John Newcomb's serve. I'm very impressed with the way Jimmy Connors has served. He's moving the ball around. He's taking good advantage of his kick serve, yet he runs it wide sometimes in the ad court.
Anticipation by Newcomb. Remarkable.
He also made a good deep approach shot. Connors didn't have quite as much time to get set up to make his stroke. 15 all.
Time that.
Well, the kick jumped out and away, and he did mistime it, mishit it, went well over the baseline. You got to give Connors some credit for the kick that he's putting on that ball. The ball doesn't just come straight at you, it jumps up and off to the side.
Got the tape.
40-50.
Wouldn't have mattered. That was going to be wide. I don't think John was happy with his shot selection that time. He was not really in a position to go for a winner. 40-15.
That's first service. Out, second service.
First serve hit the net, bounced wide. Second serve also bounces wide to the sideline.
40-30.
First double fall for Connors.
Right, and he served four aces. Newcomb served four aces, but he also served four double faults. I think he'll go wide this time, Pat. So he goes up the middle. That's how much I know about it. And with a good first serve, Connors holds on, and it's now one all in the third set.
A lot of ones on the scoreboard. Sets are 1-1, and games are 1-1.
Third set.
Newcomb to serve now, just below us. The near court, Connors at the other end.
Double fall.
Number five.
You know, you've got to try that kind of a serve against Connors because his return of serve is so devastating. You might as well either make a good one or he's going to knock it past you, probably.
Put a cripple up there. It's like conceding the point.
Set up by the good offensive lob. Newcomb could barely get to it, tapped it back weakly, and Connors jumped all over the one-hander. It's love 30. Bad toss that time. Sort of got hooked up in his fingers. It didn't get up as high as he wanted it.
Body English again. Of a different sort.
Almost came
You'd
over.
You'd like me to wiggle more, baby, I tell you.
Little conversation with someone. Part of our interested spectators is Phyllis McGuire. Everybody looks nervous, Pat. Intent, but nervous. They can feel the pressure.
Well, it's been building a long time. All this week. Long before that, too.
Look at that serve. Served him very tight. Jammed him.
30.
Broke it right into his body.
That's right. Excuse me, Pat. One of the things that's difficult when you're serving, when a player moves from side to side, as Connors does, is try to figure out his move so that he can serve into it. Of course, he's trying to get to the side of the ball. Dirty all.
Super volley. Here it is.
Good first serve. Jimmy runs around, hits it down the line, and the backhand volley cross court for perfect placement. Back lie with Newcomb serving 40-30. Tremendous serve, tremendous return for a winner. That kid really has quick hands. It's deuce. I think Jimmy changed his mind that time. He was going to lob, and then he decided to try to roll a short cross court, and he did a little bit of both.
In the middle of the swing.
Right. That happens.
Possibly. Beautiful shot. And again, it worked for Connor. Here it is coming.
Let's watch Newcomb. After he makes his first foul, watch how he closes forward. He moves in, looking for the passing shot, dead. No chance. The ball goes in, which it did, with plenty to spare. Deuce, back live, Newcomb, serve. Ball.
That's out. Advantage, Newcomb. Diana Shore sitting alongside Jack Snyder.
Famous Hank Greenberg,
Greenberg
down the right-hand corner. You talk about people that like tennis. Hank Greenberg plays all the time.
And a very, very good player.
Good player, loves to play doubles.
Ball, double fault.
Way long double fault by Newcomb that time. He missed by 2 feet.
Hank and the famous Joe Louis. I had the pleasure of shaking Joe's hand last night. Talk about heavyweight champions.
How's your hand?
He was nice to me. He didn't put the vice on me. We said, Joe, who do you like tomorrow night? He says, I like the young legs.
Meeting, of course, Jimmy Connors, who's just 22.
Newcomb smashes this ball in the air, though it was very high. Connors gets it back, lets it go and blows. But it was going out anyway.
I think it was.
And Newcomb has the advantage.
We'll be back with more tennis action in the Connors-Newcomb Challenge match in just a moment.
Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday, dear Tony.
When you're in a mood to do something nice for yourself, consider a 75 Buick, an Electra. A car is so nice, if you're giving it to someone special, well, who deserves it more than you?
And many more.
Buick, dedicated to the free spirit in just about everyone.
You're the one. You are the only reason. You're the one. We take pride in pleasing. You're why we serve the best. That's McDonald's style. You're why we keep it clean. You're what makes us smile. You're the one that we We've been looking for you. You're the one. We've got it cooking for. You're why we're always near, close by, right on your way. You're why we keep our prices low.
Next Saturday and Sunday afternoon, CBS will continue its coverage of the NBA playoffs with a game from each of the conference final series. In the West, Golden State against Chicago. And in the Eastern Finals, Boston against Washington. Our Saturday broadcast will begin at 3 p.m. Eastern time, and on Sunday afternoon, tip-off is at 1 p.m. Eastern. You'll see both games next weekend on CBS. Right now, Connors and Newcomb from Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. A broadcast that's going all over the world, as well as the United States, to Mexico, Japan, the Netherlands, England, Philippines, Hong Kong, Germany, and New Zealand. Pretty good audience. You nervous?
I'm nervous. Going to Australia, going to Hawaii.
Quiet, please.
Connors on the left, Newcomb on the right.
I just hope all our viewers are enjoying it as much as I am. Super tennis match. Really very well played by both players. They've been good sportsmanship throughout.
No, baby.
Sets are one apiece, and Newcomb leads in this third set. 2-1. Connors serving. 15 love.
Out.
You know, Pat, they had an interesting thing here. They discovered yesterday that one end of the court, the side that Connors is playing in now, was 1.75 inches too long. So last night they took the baseline off and put a new baseline on where it should be. Newcomb trying to change pace a little bit. Another backhand up the line, missed by about a foot. As Connor stands about 3 feet from the center stripe serving the edge court, so that when he wants to, he can slide it wide, it'll break farther. A right-hander would do it if he wanted to on the other side serving the deuce court.
Double ball. That's his second. And as Newcomb did the last time, he did it at 40 love.
Just out over the baseline, so comfortably Jimmy Connors holds serve to level at 2-2 in the third set. Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. 250 G's, Pat Summerall, for the winner.
In addition to the 150 that he gets for just for coming and playing. So, $400,000 and upwards. For the winner of this match. Newcomb serving.
It's just marvelous. Newcomb hits a serve, who knows, 120, 30, 40 miles an hour. Connors hits it back almost as hard. They place a volley right in the corner. It's tough to win a point these days.
Sure is fun to watch, though.
Well, you play, you appreciate it.
In a different league. Again, that rocket return of service by Connors.
You know, I really felt that Connors would win because Newcomb has not played as much tournament tennis recently, and there's just something about the instinct and that just fraction of a second with the hands that seems to let you down when you haven't played a lot.
Connors was the favorite, 8-5. As established by the odds makers. Right now, it's very even. One set apiece, two games apiece in the third set.
And it's 15-30.
Service kit.
All.
High in the backhand side by Newcomb. Jimmy got over for the two-hander and really mistimed it. Pancho Segura, that's Mrs. Segura in the back in the blue with a white trim, and Pancho's daughter, and that's Mrs. Connors on the right, looking worried, very intent. I guess it's safe to say she's sort of an intense person.
At a time like this, it's understandable. She's a tennis player herself and quite a good one.
Double ball, 30, 40. Number seven by Newcomb, and it's break point for Jimmy Connors. 30-40. There have been two service breaks. Connors broke once to win the first set. Newcomb broke once to win the second set.
Ball.
Action of the Connors Newcomb Challenge match in just a moment.
You know, a new light beer from Miller is everything you've always wanted in a beer. And less. Less filling. Because it has less carbohydrates and one-third less calories than a regular beer. I didn't drink all this beer by myself. I had a little help from my friend. But imagine a great tasting beer that's less filling. And at 6'3", 230. There's a lot of me to fill.
Come on.
New Light. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Some guys are into woodworking, and they've got to have every new gadget that comes out. Not me. I keep it simple. Because the simpler things are, the better I like them. Like shaving with this Wilkinson Bonded. It's so simple. Take changing blades. Out. In. There it is. One blade, Wilkinson Sharp, makes getting a clean, close shave a cinch. I use the bonded razor and blade from Wilkinson Sword because I like things simple. The simpler, the better.
Buick has taken the concept of a V8 and created something pretty special, the Buick V6. It shares design efficiencies with our V8s, but with greater fuel economy. And it's so good, we've made it standard on three entirely different sized Buicks, the small rakish Skyhawk, the compact Skylark, and the midsize Century. It means you can drive your idea of an economy car and enjoy a Buick at the same time. Buick, dedicated to the free spirit in just about everyone.
Jimmy Connors has just broken John Newcomb in the third set. Take the lead 3-2. And both Connors and Newcomb have put on clean shirts during this court change.
Same colors, same stripes, so that you shouldn't be confused. They're just dry shirts.
Sets are 1-1. Connors leads now, serving in the third set, 3-2.
Just saw one of my head counts as my camp, Peter Nicklin, here enjoying the tennis.
Full house at Tennis Pavilion at Caesar's Palace. Full house. Call good, and Newcomb doesn't believe. And Gus Lennon acknowledges that that was a fault.
Apparently, the linesman said unsighted, because otherwise Gus Lennon could not do that. He said it was referred to the chair.
Perfect. What a shot. A rocket shot.
15, with a lot of topspin, he really pounded that one. I just want to explain that. If a linesman says, "I didn't see it," the umpire has a right to call it. If he saw it, if he's not sure, you play a let. Seen situations where an umpire will overrule a linesman. That's not in the rules. It's against the rules.
Another good
example of that great eyesight.
Connor's approach shot seemed to stay a little bit lower than Nuke expected. Sort of had a jab at the ball, and Jimmy was there, but wisely let it go. And Connors is becoming a little more aggressive than he had been for several games. Whoa! Service ace by Connors, who now leads 4-2 in the third set. That's ace number five for Jimmy.
Four games to two, third set.
Sort of an interesting statistic, Pat, at this stage. Connors has served five aces and two double faults. Newcomb has served four aces and seven double faults. One of those double faults came in his last service game, which he lost.
Look at Connors get back. What an effort. Look at that again.
Play by Newcomb, because he makes the drop 15. Shot that lets Connors get to the ball, and he's so close to him that he has no chance. Newcomb was looking for the ball to go cross court. Connors went down the line. We're back live. The first serves a fault. 2-4, love 15, the third set. Sets are one all.
Same sort of maneuver to the other side.
The last shot was the easy part. The good shot was one down at the feet. Newcomb's half volley sat up, and he just knocked it away. Love 30. Bill Reardon happily applauds.
Connor's now just 1 point away from another service break.
Triple break point. This would just about salt that third set away. Two service breaks against a guy like Connors is pretty tough.
There it is.
Jimmy Connors, break serve to lead 5-2 in the third set.
We'll be back with more tennis action. The Connors-Newcomb challenge match in just a moment.
Do you know me? People often look at me and say, you're somebody. But they haven't the foggiest notion who. That's why I carry an American Express card. I use it in stores, restaurants, airlines, hotels worldwide, even in places where they've never seen my pretty face. True, it's a bit more difficult to get, but it means much more when you get it.
To apply for a card, call 800-528-8000.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
1975 Opel. To those of you who have admired Opel's rugged disposition and frugal four-cylinder engine, we make this brief but proud announcement. Fuel injection. Now in Opel Manta, 1900 sedan, and sport wagon. These special edition Opels are at your Buick Opel dealer now. But you'd better hurry, because you know what happens when you put fuel injection in great little cars like these. They go fast. Buick's Opel, dedicated to the free spirit in just about everyone.
How do you spell relief?
When I have heartburn, I spell relief, R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
For acid indigestion, I spell it R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. In this test with Rolaid's active ingredient, laboratory acid changes color to prove Rolaid's consumes 47 times its weight in excess stomach acid. How do you spell relief?
For gas, I know. R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief.
While we're away, Pancho Segura is talking to Jimmy Connors, saying that John Newcomb might be just a little bit tired now. And he was also praising the way Connors had played that last game. And Connors has really gotten himself pumped up now.
Pancho also said, concentrate on these first two serves. Get them in. I don't care where you try to hit them. Get them in. He said, John will not come in on you. because he's a little bit tired.
See that necklace around Connor's neck? That says super. A gift from Chris Evans.
A little earlier, he looked at it and said, "You've let me down. You've deserted me."
Didn't look like it that last game. By the way, we mentioned that this broadcast was going around the world, including to Australia, Newcomb's home country. Whereas early Sunday morning.
That's lives. They got to get up early.
I imagine most of them are up, too.
15-all
the score. Connors leads, and this is the third set, 5-2. He won the first one. Newcomb won the second one.
There's that necklace you can see. Chrissy wears one that Jimmy gave her with the initials JC. That's for Jimmy Connors.
I wasn't going to ask.
Okay. Aggressive, but perhaps a little bit careless on a couple of points this game. Connors is trailing 15-30. Newcomb needs two breaks to get even. Double break point. 15-40. Double break point for Newcomb. Connor's leading 5-2 in the third set. He has two breaks. You got to get him back one at a time.
And Newcomb just guessed wrong.
Connors made a good serve, but he also closed in very, very quickly. Got the ball well above the top of the net and made a good crisp volley.
Where Connors tosses the ball, way to the right, back over his head.
Save two break points.
We go back to deuce with this. Look again.
Good smash. Now, Newcomb looked like he knew what I was coming. He stayed right there. Forehand volley hit very hard. Newcomb's defensive lob went about a foot or so over the baseline. We're back live at deuce.
That's that.
And now it's set point for Connors. If he can win this point, he goes ahead 2-1. Remember, this is a best of 5 sets. John Newcomb concentrating, crouching, ready to return. Jimmy missed that serve and said, stupid. He has not been successful going up the center in the ad court. He has not made many of those serves. And a forehand winner by John Newcomb. That saves a set point. Point number 2 for Jimmy Connors. And Connors holds serve to win the third set, 6-2. He now leads 2-1.
Pancho Segura. And Jimmy's mother yelling encouragement from the box on the sideline. They want him to really go to work. See him take a look. Newcomb will serve. trailing 2-1 now. And he's got to get his game together in a hurry. Surprising, I think, if you look at the ace situation, Connors has served one more ace than Newcomb. Newcomb is supposed to have the bigger serve.
And 5 short double faults.
Out. Out. 15 love.
As I mentioned a moment ago, this is 3 out of 5 sets. Connors leading 2-1. They say this young man, Jimmy Connors, will earn at least $1 million in 1975 playing tennis. Prize money plus endorsements and appearances. It was good.
Was good.
Sort of a dangerous type volley.
He didn't need to take that much of a chance.
Backhand drop volley. Right on the line. 30 love. Service ace,
yes,
for Newcomb.
40 love.
That's his fifth.
Must have heard you, Pat.
See if we can pick up what Pancho Segura has to say
up.
To Connors.
He's coming into your on the left side.
Coming into your two-hander on the left side. That's what coaches are for. They can't tell you how to hit it, but they can tell you where to hit it. They can try to spot things. That's Clarence Mabry.
You gotta hold him off, Jimbo. Hold him off and crack.
Have to be a similar punch.
Speaking of coaches, Pat Summerall, I saw my good friend Bill Talbert here. He was our Davis Cup captain. Super guy, and he spotted something when I was playing the Davis Cup against Lou Hode that helped me pick his passing shots on the backhand side and enabled me to win the match, and Vic Stasis and I were successful in returning the Davis Cup.
Of course, Bill does such an outstanding job of winning the U.S. Open Championship at Forest Hills.
We'll be covering that on CBS.
Right. It's a great, great period of time for us, isn't it?
A piece of gum punch.
Huh? Sure is. Connors asking for some chewing gum. That's Mrs. Chad Everett sitting right behind Jimmy Connors. And her husband, Chad, was there a moment ago.
Don't you have any more gum, Mom?
Jimmy's asking, hey, Mom, don't you have any more gum?
And I'll bet you she can't find it.
John Newcomb. She can't. She can come back out.
Where's the gum?
Where's the gum, Mom? I told you she couldn't find it.
Fuck it all!
$1 million, but no gum.
Prices have gone up. Connors to serve from the far end. He leads 2-1. He's serving at love one in the fourth set.
Left, first service.
Drop shot misses.
15, love.
Low percentage try. If you don't hit it perfectly, you either hit it in the net or you hit it too deep. You bring your opponent in and he can knock it past you pretty easily.
He did a lot of work on that shot in workouts, Newcomb did. Good serve from Connors. Good lob. First overhead counter is missed. Did all the right things, too. He let it bounce. Waited.
That's right. It was a deep lob. He missed it a little bit. I guess he's human after all. He probably took his eye off the one.
He's thinking about the gum.
Newcomb seems to be handling the forehand return of serve a little better now than he did earlier in the match. He's catching it a little more squarely. Didn't overplay that overhead. He just blocked it into the open court.
Yes, sir.
Another service ace with a kick serve wide.
Right on the line.
Games are one all, four set.
There's no way he could serve an ace with that kind of a serve, Pat, except he lands it very short up the sideline, so that makes the angle greater, and then it kicks away from the right-hander. John just didn't seem to see it coming. So Connors has done that twice for service aces. Jimmy says the crowd almost had him.
Jumped on it. Both times he got the tape. Marvelous overhead from Newcomb.
Good point. Good serve, good return, a good half volley. Good offensive lob down the line. Nuke got around to hit the smash.
Ball.
40 love.
Double ball again at 40 love.
40.
Number 9.
I think Nuke got his serve exactly where he wanted it. Sort of like a pitcher that hangs that curveball and that guy jumps on it. Jimmy really popped it right past him. It's 40-30. I think he's trying to serve a little tighter that time.
Beautiful.
John Newcomb holds serve to lead 2-1 in the fourth set.
We'll be back with more tennis action of the Connors-Newcomb Challenge match in just a moment.
A wife is many things. Companion, partner, mother. Then sometimes comes the hardest job. She's a widow. With life insurance and other property, she has money now. But what about the years ahead? She needs help to plan the best use of all her benefits, help she can trust. So Aetna Life and Casualty established a benefits planning service for every life insurance policyholder. A trained representative helps her gather necessary papers, collect Social Security and other benefits, handle immediate bills. Then, when she's ready, Aetna will suggest a wise use of all her resources for steady, dependable income. This help costs her nothing. The benefits planning service backs up every Aetna life insurance policy. Ask your Aetna agent about it. When help is needed, you get action with Aetna.
We have succeeded in creating a unique wine, a dry wine, with a whisper of sweetness. Gallo Rhine Wine from Ernest and Giulio Gallo. From the finest vineyards, the finest grapes are chosen. Wine masters marry these grapes to create this unique and delicious Gallo Rhine Wine. Now enjoy this dry wine with a whisper of sweetness. Gallo Rhine with a whisper of sweetness.
America's finest amateur athletes have already begun their preparations for the greatest of international sports competitions, the Olympic Games, to be held in 1976 in Innsbruck and Montreal. Your help and financial support are important to them. If you'd like to support your Olympic team, send a $5 contribution to the U.S. Olympic Committee, Box 1000C, Cathedral Station, Boston, Massachusetts. Our athletes will, of course, appreciate your help.
And our government doesn't subsidize our Olympic team as many countries do, so if our fans don't send money, they don't wear such good clothes.
Right now, we pick up the action in the challenge match from Las Vegas between Jimmy Connors and John Newcomb, and that's the situation. Connors leads 2-1. Newcomb leads 2-1 in set number 4. The lob by Newcomb in the far court. And a good one. What a smash.
15 love.
It's one of the few times Connors smashed to the forehand side. He normally smashes into the backhand corner. That's where Newcomb went. No one was home.
That kick serve again.
Out. 30 love.
It's difficult when somebody serves the ball wide like that to change the direction and go down the line and keep it in there. It's a tough shot.
Right on the line for Connors. Three times he's done that.
40 love.
He's tried that serve up the center in the ad court many times. That's about the second time he's made it with success. New balls. So we have a little lull here, and Pat, I think we're going to have to see Newcomb pressing Connor's serve a little bit more. You know, he's by no means out of this match. I'm not intimating that, but if he can force a little bit, particularly on second serves, he might break Jimmy's game up just a little bit. Of course, if you don't hit a good shot when you come in against Connors, you can forget it.
Can't be wearing it. Newcomb got the good serve in that time. 15 love. Call the fault.
Newcomb won that point.
perfect shot right in the corner on the volley.
That's the kind of thing you have to do on the short ball rather than try, for example, the drop shot that Newcomb tried earlier and lost with it. To look around and watch the people's reaction when they
it
see
is, isn't it?
Jimmy hit one line, they just start shaking their heads, say, man, how do you do that?
That's a perfectly grooved shot. Look at that return. Service was a fault, or a call to fault.
I think Jimmy's even a little surprised himself on that one, even though it didn't count. John Newcomb holds serve to lead 3-2 in the fourth set.
We'll be back with more tennis action after this word from your local station.
This is CBS.
This is Dotson's new Lil Hustler Stretch, a foot longer version of America's number one selling small truck. It has a 7-foot bed. In it is Too Tall Jones of the Dallas Cowboys. Hey, Too Tall, comfortable in that 7-foot bed?
Yeah, and it'll still fit when I grow up.
Hello! TWA introduces Trans World Service in the USA. You'll enjoy wines of the world over Washington, continental cuisine over Colorado. You'll see foreign films over Phoenix, a great footage car left. So ask your travel agent about Transworld Service and get a taste of Europe at 30,000 feet. What? TWA.
Channel 2, New York.
That's the situation in the challenge match between Newcomb and Connors. This is Pat Summerall along with Tony Trabert. And Tony, just listening to the conversation between Pancho Segura and Connors, he was just saying, all we need is one break.
That's right. Connors is up 2-1. He figures he can hang on to his serve, so if he can get one break, he'll win the fourth set in the match.
Right now, Newcomb leads 3-2. And this is the fourth set. Connors on the right, Newcomb on the left.
Yeah. Oh. Reverse overhead by Connors. Well angled for a winner. Take a look again, we'll see, instead of slicing it as he does some of the time, he hits reversed out the other way for a clean
out.
We come back live. Newcomb missed a return of serve, and it's now 30-love.
Connors' first serve hit the line, and Newcomb hit it out. 30-love the score.
Out.
He knew that as soon as
30,
he touched it.
15.
Jimmy said, playing like my little brother. I understand he quit at the age of 12. Fine forehand volley.
15.
Amazing reflexes.
And it was punched nicely. Good underspin. Not a big swing at it. Used the speed on the ball. Serve was long.
It's 40-15. 40-30.
The kind of thing I was talking about, trying to rush Jimmy a little bit, take a few chances. Newcomb has only broken Connor's serve once so far in this match. Connors has broken Newcomb three times.
Well out. I think Connors thought the earlier shot was out. Looking over at the linesman now, see? I'll get you.
But he was smart. He played the ball.
Right.
You don't let it go and then worry about the call.
Great serve. Down the line.
Yeah, and that had some slice on it. It was breaking away from Newcomb. Serving is so much, I think, like pitching. You know, you've changed pace, you've changed positioning, changed the spins.
Another big serve by Jimmy Connors. Twice he went down the line to win that game, something he hadn't been able to do earlier in the match. Games are 3-3 now. Sets are 2-1 in favor of Connors.
I don't see that Newcomb is particularly slowing down from a fatigue standpoint. Some people thought that might be the situation. Connors at 22 never slows down.
One of the comments made about Newcomb was that although serving takes so much out of many people, he seems to get stronger.
Need good stomach muscles to be able to serve consistently well and for a long period of time. Newcomb starts back, and then he stops. And then he says, oh, it's on the line. Now I got to get going. He came back and hit the forehand in the net. 15-all.
Super point.
Is this man serving the best player in the world? Or is Jimmy Connors receiving the best player in the world?
Right now, Connors looks like the best.
15-30.
Connors is 2 points away from that service break that he said he needed so badly.
He's there again.
Oh, perfect smash.
He called it out.
Oh, you gotta be kidding.
He called it out. And the crowd is on its feet.
Linesman, be sure you fall.
Gotta be kidding.
15-40.
All right, now Gus Land, the umpire, did the only thing he can do. He asked the linesman, are you sure of your call? He said yes. The umpire cannot overrule a linesman. Terrible break.
The linesman said he was sure of his call. 15-40.
Terrible break. It's double break point now.
15-40 the score.
John Newcomb taking a little bit of a walk. I'm sure Connors is thinking now, down in Australia, this situation came up, and I served a double fault, gave a point away, and I lost. I ain't about to do it this time.
He's on record as saying, I'll never do that again. He feels that cost him that match. Good return of service. That's the winner.
And Newcomb breaks serve to go ahead 4-3.
We'll be back with more tennis action in the Connors Newcomb Challenge match in just a moment.
This is a 1975 Buick LeSabre with superb styling, elegant interior, abundant comfort and convenience. But LeSabre has more functional assets, like
like a strong engine, plenty of wheelbase, lots of room, a big trunk, and heft. Yes, LeSabre is most functional. It's just that it functions with Buick's style and Buick comfort. For some people, that makes LeSabre one of life's necessities. Buick, dedicated to the free spirit in just about everyone.
You never saw a shaver, blade or electric, that will do this for you. This is the new Shave Master Groomer from Sunbeam. The shaver that gives you more than a shave. It adjusts to groom your beard, mustache, keeps you neat between haircuts, and gives you a clean, close shave with both holes and slots. Here, in Sunbeam's thinnest shaving head ever, get the groomer. The Shave Master Groomer from Sunbeam.
Hey, Woody Walters, rock drummer. How's your love life?
Man, our last tour covered 72 cities, including L.
Woody, Woody, your love life? How is it?
Nowhere.
How's your love life?
Maybe yours needs Ultra Bright. Dynamite taste and more whitener than any leading toothpaste. Ultra Bright, the one that puts sex appeal in a tube, wants to know.
How's your love life?
Ultra Bright is available to help yours.
Pancho Segura keeps telling Jimmy Connors that Newcomb is tired.
The speed is gone, he says. You got him. I want to correct one thing. Excitement of closing that last game out. I said Newcomb broke. He was broken by Connors, obviously. So Connors is serving at 4-3 in the fourth set. He leads 2-1. All he has to do is hold serve twice, and he will be the winner in four sets in this winner-take-all match against John Newcomb.
By the way, Segura asked Connors in that last visit to the bench in the court change if that ball that shot by Newcomb was out. And Connors said, yes, I thought it was.
He also referred to Australia, saying, I gave him something in Australia and I'm not going to do it again. We can hear that because we have a hand mic down near where they sit when they change courts. 15 all.
Good shot by Newcomb.
Not hit hard, but angled cross court and low.
Nuke needs to break back. And he needs to get it done right now.
15-30. Connor's taking a little more time. Careful not to hit the net with his racket on the follow-through. Had he done so, he would have lost the point. 30 all. All set up by a fine wide serve. Place serve.
14-30.
Newcomb did a good job to get it back at all. The two-handed volley finished it. Game point for Connors. Service eight. So Connors, to the applause of Bill Reardon and the crowd, lead 5-3 in the fourth set.
He leads already 2-1. He won the first one 6-3. Newcomb won the second one 6-4. Connors broke Newcomb twice to take the third set 6-2. He leads 5-3 with Newcomb serving in the fourth set.
Out.
As a comparison, when Connors played labor here, Jimmy won 6-4, 6-2, 3-6, 7-5. Good
eight.
Serve. Number six.
30, love.
Would Connors be coasting now just a bit?
Not at all. Not at all. He'd like to break serve right here and get it over with.
That's out.
30-15.
He has no stamina problem. He can go the distance. The way he returns serve, he figures maybe I can get another break right here and end it.
He was up on this one. He couldn't. That's too good a serve. He got back. Now let's see Newcomb win.
Yeah. Oh, you're by those players. The first time we've had any type thing out of Newcomb.
He's been a deadpan so far.
It's 40-15.
Serve any better than that.
40-30.
And still lost it.
You can't return any better than that either.
Deuce.
Connors is 2 points away from wrapping it up. Well, that serve missed about 8 feet. Good serve by Newcomb.
Advantage Newcomb.
Advantage Newcomb.
Yeah. He holds.
And Newcomb trails 5-4 in the fourth set.
We'll be back with more tennis action of the Connors Newcomb Challenge match in just a moment.
Mr. Connors Lee.
Michelob. One beer. One beer, so good. One beer, so good, people don't expect you to serve it. Michelob. It's an unexpected pleasure. One beer, so good.
The Penn Center Court tennis balls tell you a lot about this man. They tell you that when he walks onto the court, tennis is all that matters. He's serious about tennis. And he takes the time to find out about tennis equipment. He knows that Penn Center Court balls and tennis accessories are made by General Tire, the people who make more tennis balls than anyone else in America. Penn Center Court, the serious tennis ball.
You can buy a powder to help keep your feet dry, and you can buy a cooling foot refresher, and you can buy an athlete's foot treatment, or you can buy Desinex. Desinex does it all. Sprayed into shoes and boots, it helps keep feet dry and comfortable. Sprayed through stockings, it soothes and cools hot, tired, aching feet. And medicated Desinex powder helps relieve itchy, burning, peeling feet. Athlete's foot. Desinex. It does a lot more than just fight athlete's foot.
Pancho Segura and Jimmy Connors, and Connors sounds like he might be sick.
He's actually retching. Almost close to throwing up.
Hear that?
Swallow my gum.
Newcomb is already back on the court.
He said
swallowed
I
his chewing gum.
Swallowed my gum.
Connors is up and ready. Segura said, come on, Jimmy, we just got one more game. We got him.
Again, he said, serve the first 2 points wherever you want to serve it. But get in. Newcomb's getting fired up. There's no tomorrow. He either breaks her here or the lights are out.
Connors leads 5-4, five games to four in the fourth set. Sets are his 2-1, thinking about upwards of $400,000 to the winner of this challenge match. Plus,
sure
perhaps the end of the argument as to who's the best player in the world.
I don't know if I can get my arm back if I'm playing for that kind of dough.
Way out by Newcomb.
15-12.
A guy like Newcomb does not choke in a situation like this. It's do or die. Either make some shots or it's all over.
Away from that big purse. Newcomb likened preparation for this match to getting ready for the Davis Cup. He worked very hard.
Jimmy Connors, 40 love, 5-4 in the fourth set. All the marbles right down to this shot.
Right down to the middle again.
He went for Brooke.
He was successful twice there in the last game, the last time he served. Point. Embraced by his mother and by Bill Reardon and Pancho Segura. We'll be back with the presentation and the talk with the players in just a moment.
Bill?
Hello, Fresh Face.
Not yet. I need a little help from Maybelline.
Freshest face I've ever seen.
I love it when friends say, you have gorgeous skin. That's the look I get with Fresh and Lovely Liquid Makeup by Maybelline. Just enough cover to hide what I want to hide. Never looks made up, even in bright sunlight. And that's the real test. Yet it doesn't cost a fortune.
Fresh and Lovely Liquid Makeup.
Hello, Fresh Face.
That's me.
With a little help from Maybelline.
This lone self-propelled Eager One is attempting to cut every blade of grass in Lanesville, Indiana. It's a small town, but it's mostly quarter-acre lots. Eager One starts first time almost every time, and its self-propelled drive really cuts work. We accidentally hit this buried object and had to replace a crankshaft, but the same Eager One finished the job. Here's the result, as much grass as you'd probably cut in years. Craftsman Eager One, eager to start, eager to finish.
If you've been waiting to buy a new car, consider this. Buick has just introduced two new versions of their popular V6-powered Skyhawk and Skylark. They're called Skyhawk S and Skylark S. And their manufacturer's suggested retail price is hundreds of dollars less than previous models, which means that all of a sudden, you and a new Buick are hundreds of dollars closer. That's good news. Buick, to the free spirit.
The crowd is around Connors. In the meantime, at the other end of the court, Newcomb is alone with his coach, Clarence Mabry. In four sets, Jimmy Connors won challenge match number two. He has beaten Laver and Newcomb, both convincingly.
He also got his first win over John Newcomb. And to show you the way things have changed, they had to get security guards out around Connors to keep the crowd away. And now Jimmy Connors is being escorted over into the winner's circle.
Newcomb is already there, standing back against the net. Jack Whitaker, our colleague, is down courtside. Let's go down to Jack now.
All right, Jimmy Connors, could we have you here, please? Right over here. Ladies and gentlemen, the president of Caesar's Palace, Mr. Bill Weinberger.
Jimmy, congratulations, Jimmy. It's good to meet you here again. On behalf of the employees and the management of Caesar's Palace, it's my pleasure to present you with this check for $250,000. Jimmy, it was a great match.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. It's really there. Thank you very much, Mr. Weinberger, and thank you, everybody. I think today I played one of the greatest tennis players of all time. And I hope that with you people here, with everything that was said, that what I said and what John said, that all goes in the game, and that, you know, if I'm playing Wimbledon and Foresters, I hope that John is there and that we meet again, maybe in a match like this soon.
All right. We have something more for you here. Just a minute, Jimmy. Mr. Bill Berger of the Buick Corporation, General Sales Manager.
John, or Jimmy, congratulations again. A couple months ago, a new Buick. Today, on behalf of Buick and our dealer organization, a check made out to the Vince Lombardi Cancer Foundation at Georgetown University, as you so designated. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much. I don't think I can go without thanking everybody here for coming today. You, as always, people here at Caesar's Palace and the people in the audience were fantastic. But I also think that the linesmen and the ball boys deserve a lot because of me on the one side of the court for one reason. But they did a great job. The ball boys were inconspicuous, and the linesmen did the best they could on a lot of the fastballs that were going around. So I'd like to thank them also. Thank you very much.
All right, Jimmy. Congratulations. We'll be right back here at Caesar's Palace after this word.
I'll show you my check.
Hey, Jay.